Welcome to sunny Winter Haven, Florida. I'm Lane Dog Bowers, and I want you to realize that you are greatly blessed, highly favored, and deeply loved. And this is the fifth video I've done. I can't believe it's turned into five videos on something I'm just so excited about. If you haven't seen the movie The Secret, I absolutely recommend you see that. It's a life-changing movie. And as I was studying that, I was simultaneously studying something that is I've been really interested in a long time, is skillful and godly wisdom. And I've done four videos on it. And what these have been about is what I have called the secret kept secret from the movie The Secret. And this is the fifth thing that I want to talk to you about, is a critical component in the movie The Secret, was that you can be and do and have anything you want in life by holding an image in your mind, by clearly defining, holding that image, being thankful, and having faith in circumstances that may not be the ones you want, because all of the circumstances in your life, both good and bad, have been attracted from what you have previously held in your mind, thought about, and mixed with emotions. Tough pill to swallow, but if you can get past that and say, okay, I didn't think I attracted necessarily a disease that I had or an accident or whatever, but the truth is, yes, you did. The greatest example of that in the Bible on a negative standpoint is that Job greatly feared, and all of those things he feared about, the power of what you hold in your mind is an image, and your ability to mix that with emotions will bring into your life. As a man thinketh in his heart, so is he. There's an entire book written by that, which is just amazing, As a Man Thinketh. But today I want to talk to you about one of the most key components of that whole thing is faith. And what I've said all along is that the missing secret, kept secret from the movie The Secret, is that none of this would have happened. All of it is based on God's word, even though it's a bit diluted in the movie. I'm not sure if it's because they didn't want to offend people, or they wanted to make it more available to other people by not bringing out the fact, but the fact is, it is based on God's word. And in the Bible, it talks about faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Now, that always puzzled me, how it said hearing, comma, and hearing by the word of God. First of all, it's actually not the word of God, it's the word of Christ. Because faith does actually not come when you concentrate on the Ten Commandments, or you concentrate on verses in the Bible that are not in light of Jesus' finished work. If you concentrate on verses without having a revelation that it is all about Jesus and his finished work and how much God loves you, and he gave us this ability. The only thing we can control in our lives is the ability and the power to direct our minds. That's why this next thing is absolutely critical and just so foundational to good success. I am not talking here just about money. I'm talking about what the Bible calls shalom, wholeness, restoration, prosperity, health, peace of mind, peace for more. It's just an amazing concept of which the English word has no equivalent, okay? So let's get back to faith. Faith comes by hearing and hearing. And I was wondering, why hearing, comma, and then hearing? And you know, I want to share with you at least five verses that I wrote down. But like, for instance, to the Jewish mind, that is abundantly clear, because they always say Shema, Shema, which is hear, hearing. It's like God is telling us it's not enough to hear one time. And in the movie The Secret, they talk about every day you have to keep that image in your mind, close your eyes, concentrate on that goal that you've set for yourself, that desire you have, see that coming past in the future, and feel with mixed with emotion those feelings and experience it. And if you can experience it, if it has already happened, you will vibrate an energy that will attract everything you need. All of that is based on God's word. So I want to talk to you about faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of Christ. And in the Old Testament, one of the most amazing collections of blessings, I think I'm standing under a wasp's nest here. The greatest collections of blessings are in, I think it's Deuteronomy 28. Go read those for yourself. They're amazing. But I used to read those when I was younger. I think, oh man, that is, these are like, you are going to be unstoppable force of nature to deal with when you just, you know, are in God's word. And, you know, I want to, but the thing is, when it says in there, listen to this, these are five, well, first of all, wait, before I get into those verses, I want to talk something about the New Testament. Paul was preaching in a city called Lystra. I didn't write the verses down, but he was teaching in a city called Lystra. And there was a certain man there who did not have strength in his feet enough to walk. He was lame. And he was, it says in the verses that he was listening to Paul as he preached. And then Paul, it said, preached. But the thing to hear about that is that both that word that he listened to Paul, and then that verb is actually in the imperfect tense, which means that it wasn't finished. It was incomplete. He did it over and over again. So this man who is listening to Paul was listening and listening. Maybe that Paul preached in a certain area and then people dispersed, and then later Paul would preach again. But this man kept listening and listening. And also it says that Paul preached, also in imperfect tense, that Paul preached and preached. So as Paul was preaching and preaching the good news, the gospel of peace, this man heard it over and over. And somewhere along the way, he was filled with faith. Paul saw that he had faith and told the man to stand up, and the man jumped and leaped and was completely made whole. You know, that is so amazingly powerful. So the powerful thing about it is he heard and he heard. And I never knew that about that verse. So I want to talk to you about the power of hearing and hearing. It is not enough to hear at one time. Another amazing thing missing from The Secret is that you can think about any positive image and hold it in your mind, actually positive or negative, over and over again, and you can't attract that to you. But the real power of this is a much higher quality of words, a much higher level of words than just any words and thoughts. God's words and thoughts are much more powerful than just simple positive thinking and, you know, pink Cadillacs and, you know, houses and money and gold. I mean, those, you know, that's all good. I think God wants us to have it. He doesn't want us to seek after those things. He wants us to put it in order, put it in the right order, so that He can give us good success. Now listen, here's the verses I want to share with you. I'm going to go through them quickly, but I'll post them on my blog. Is in Exodus 15:26. It says, if thou wilt diligently hearken to the voice of the Lord thy God. And that is actually, diligently hearken is actually the Hebrew Shema, Shema. If they will listen and listen, listening. You know, it's actually the same thing that Solomon prayed for. He prayed for a hearing heart to be able to judge God's people. And that, he you know, our heart apparently has ears. So we need to pray that God gives us a hearing heart so that we will hear His wisdom. It'll settle down in us, and then, you know, we'll be able to bring heaven on earth. And all the things we desire are given to us, not by seeking after things we desire, but by hearing and hearing. That's how faith comes. Later on in Deuteronomy 11:13, it says, so if you faithfully obey. See, I read that stuff and I was discouraged because I'd listened to all the commandments. I go, there's no way. So why today, in light of, and this is why it's important to hear hearing by the word of Christ and not necessarily God there, it's by Christ, is that why do we not have to obey all the commandments that are listed here that they're talking about diligently obeying? It's because Jesus, God loved us so much, He sent Jesus. Jesus was the one who was the only one who ever walked on earth who obeyed all of the law, fulfilled the law, and praise be to God, praise be to Jesus, we are under grace and not under law. So now we do have a part. Our part is to, where it says, if you will faithfully obey, it's actually, you can talk to one of your Jewish friends, it means Shema, Shema. If you will hear, hearing. It's not enough to just hear once. Keep on hearing. When you hear a sermon or something that motivates you, maybe this motivates you, play it over and over again. And when you feel faith rise inside you, that's the power of God working in your life. That's what's so powerful. That's what's missing in The Secret, is that it's much more than just any image and any thought. It's God's word and God's thoughts and God's images. And then a third example is only if thou carefully hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God. Again, that's the word Shema, Shema, and then all the blessings will overtake you. And then one more in Isaiah 55, it says, why then do you spend money on that which is not bread, and you labor for that which satisfieth not? Hearken diligently, again, Shema, Shema, unto me, and eat that which is good, and let your soul delight itself in fatness, abundance. Incline your ear, and come unto me. Hear, and your soul shall live. All those blessings are yours. The desires of your heart are yours. How do you get them? So simple. Keep on hearing. Find someone who brings out of the Word of God, Jesus. You'll feel faith rise. You'll feel the gospel of hope, the gospel of peace rising up in you, and you'll get fired up when you hear that. And when you do that, find those things again and keep on hearing. Keep on hearing and hearing, and you will be blessed with all of the promises of God that He has in Deuteronomy 28, I think it is. So I hope this inspired you. I'm going to leave you all these verses on my blog. God bless you. I'm expecting a miracle for you today.